In this problem, we're going to take a look at depreciation. So the first transaction here says, on August 1st, the company used cash to purchase an automobile to be used in the business. The cost of the auto was $1,600. It had a salvage value of $400, which is what the estimate is that we think we could sell the asset for at the end of its useful life, and a useful life of 5 years. Now, you got to be careful when you're doing these problems because they'll sometimes give you a bunch of information right at the start that you don't need right away. And in this case, when we're recording just the purchase of the automobile, we'll only need the cost. All long-term assets are purchased and recorded at their original cost, in this case, $1,600. The salvage value and useful life will become relevant to us in the next step when we actually have to record depreciation on this asset. So focusing on just the $1,600, we're going to start out by decreasing cash by that amount. Next, we're going to record an increase to the automobile account for the same amount. Again, all assets, long-term assets, are recorded at their original cost, and that's the case here. And you can see our basic accounting equation is still in balance as we decreased one asset and increased another. In terms of cash flow here, we did have a cash flow impact, and this would be investing activities, and it would be a minus. Okay, let's flash forward now to the second transaction. December 31st, adjust the records to record the depreciation on the automobile. Here's where we're going to need to do a calculation for depreciation. Now, if you've taken a look at your readings, there is a calculation for depreciation we use, which involves the original cost of the asset, which is $1,600. We'll just do this calculation right here. Minus the salvage value of $400. Divided by the asset's useful life, which in this case is 5 years. If you do the math on this, you should get a total of $240 per year in depreciation. The problem is that's the depreciation for the entire year because we use the useful life in years at the bottom part of our formula. We'll need to get this down into a month-by-month amount, and so we'll need to take that $240, and we'll need to divide it by 12 months to get a monthly amount of $20. Now, we just simply need to ask ourselves, how many months have passed? Well, all of August, September, October, November, December, or a total of 5 months have passed in depreciation. So at $20 per month, we'll do this calculation right here, times 5 months, we should have a total depreciation amount for that 5 month period equal to $100. Now, recording this transaction is a little different and will require that you remember a few things. First and foremost, we're not going to adjust or alter the original cost of the asset, the automobile account, in any way. Instead, what we're going to do is we're going to use an account called accumulated depreciation. And we're actually going to increase this account. Now, when we increase this account, at the same time, we also increase an expense account called depreciation expense. Now, what's weird about this accumulated depreciation account is this works as, you can see it's got a minus around here, works as what we call a contra asset. This is our asset, an automobile, and the accumulated depreciation is what we call a contra asset. So we're actually going to reflect that amount with a minus, as strange as that sounds. Think of these two accounts as basically going together. So this account and this account offset each other. So we're going to record that $100 as a minus. We're going to record an increase to the expense. Now, to balance out our equation, we just need to follow the same rules we've followed before. If expenses increase, we know the impact to net income is also to decrease net income. expenses goes up, net income goes up, goes down. And if net income goes down, we know the impact retained earnings is also a decrease. By decreasing retained earnings on this side of the equation and increasing, as strange as that sounds, accumulated depreciation on this side, we actually balance out our equation. So just remember when recording depreciation that you're not going to record anything to the original asset. There is a calculation called net book value, which basically takes these two balances and combines them. So $1,600 minus $100 or whatever balance is in your accumulated depreciation account equals the net book value of your asset on that December 31st, which in this case would be $1,500.